First of all, I would like to extend my thanks to the organizers of this great show, which will go on for next three more days, as I have told. Though it's not a very, you know, when I was working in Government of India for 5 years in Ministry of Shipping and Coal, a couple of years back, I must have attended n number of you know, national and international conferences like these, and I always fear the slot given to you after lunch, because half the day is gone, food is there in your tummy, and it becomes really tough to hold the attention of this august audience. But kindly bear with us, I won't take long. You see, Uttar Pradesh is the largest state in the country. It's not one of the largest, as all of you know. We have roughly around 200 million people. But what we really felt in year 2013 after the new government came, that in rural economy sector, there were many areas in which we were really lagging behind. I'll explain in my presentation. So we came up with a comprehensive poultry development policy, which basically focuses on entrepreneurs. This scheme was took almost 2-3 years to, you know, go through the preparation level and all that. And as you can see, it was finally launched by the Honorable CM in 2013. And this culminated a month back, when in last 1 year, UP did something exceptional work in dairy sector and in poultry. More so in dairy, less so in poultry. I'll explain in my presentation. And our effort was recognized. We were chosen as the best animal husbandry state in the country. As you can see, the award being given by the Home Minister of the country. I will straightway come to the presentation. The poultry population in UP, if you see the livestock census, has increased from 178 lakhs to 186 lakhs in 2012. After 2012, with the launch of this policy, there has been a huge rise. The production status in Uttar Pradesh, as you can see, eggs, if I convert the figures into crores, 160 crore, 11-12, 165, 181, 207. A jump of 40 crore eggs in just 3 to 4 years. Poultry meat 175 to 304, almost an increase of 80%. Now, here comes the flip side. The availability of eggs to the population, basically through your indigenous production, plus huge procurement from other states, is just 25 per head per annum, X. National average is 58. And Indian Nutrition Academy, Hyderabad, talks about 182. There's a huge gap. There's a huge potential. Chicken meat, roughly 1 kg. 2.2 national average. INA says 11 kg per head per annum. Huge gap, huge potential. Now, this is because of simply a huge number of population, almost crossing 200 million. It's a huge consumption state. Only a small portion, less than 10% of total consumption of the state in this sector, is met through state-produced poultry. UP produces major poultry feed ingredients like maize, rice bran, rice polish, broken rice, and wheat bran. It's a major producer. Based on self-production and procurement, the availability reaches, which I explained, 25x and 1 kg of chicken per head per annum. More than 70% of the eggs and chicken meat in UP is consumed in urban areas, which is around roughly around 32-33% of the total population. But interestingly, the demand is increasing in rural areas also for the last few years. The cost of egg production in UP is pretty low. It gives you a comparative advantage. Now, India has, as we are all sitting here, we have adequate parent stock, hatcheries, equipment manufacturing required for poultry industry, which can come to UP and establish themselves. Now, if we see the gap, critical gap, of what the Nutrition Academy says and what we get in UP, there's a critical gap of 50 eggs per head per annum and 174 eggs per head per annum. In case of meat, this is 10 kg per head per annum if you really want to reach the level at which the average of the what is really required. So what I'm trying to say that we are nowhere in consumption. The huge gap in availability and requirement of eggs and broiler chicks, it exists in the state. As you can see, I showed you the figures. And when we launched this policy, the requirement came because we analyzed in 2012 that we were importing 1 crore egg per day for our population and 10 crore broiler chicks annually for the state consumption. So we wanted to fill this gap and produce locally. So to bridge this gap, to attain self-sufficiency in poultry production and development of entrepreneurship in poultry sector, this policy, Poultry Policy 2013, was launched. In both the areas of commercial layer as well as broiler parent. Now, what we are offering to you, we are offering interest assistance, that's a reimbursement, of 10% annual interest on the bank loan taken by the entrepreneur, with a maximum of 40 lakhs for 1 year, for 1 unit, and 45 lakh for broiler unit, per unit, spread over a span of 5 years. What we are essentially saying here, that if you establish a commercial layer unit or a broiler unit in Uttar Pradesh, your interest liability of the loan for the next 5 years is virtually taken over by the state. So this is the basic USP of this scheme. Another thing which we offered, the land, if you purchase, is exempted from stamp duty. Of course, with a small limitation of 3 acres for commercial layer and 6 acres for broiler parent. You don't require more than that. Other benefits which we offered, they include exemption on electricity duty and an interest-free loan on total VAT paid in 10 years